Hi, everybody. My name is Shedrack Akintayo, and today I'm going to be talking about open source in Africa. So let's get started. And thank you once again for allowing me to grace this event. It means a lot to me. So let's get started. So Todd said, I'm Shedrack Akintayo, software developer. I'm a developer advocate, and I also double as a technical writer. So let's talk about Africa. I mean, Africa is a continent, not a country. Africa is a continent in the world with various countries in it. Africa is quite populated, have a large number of Black people in Africa. We're about 1.216 billion people as of 2016. I mean, it should be double, it should have increased more by now. Talent. So, I mean, a lot of us have been seeing like different things coming out from Africa. And one of Africa's major export resource is talent. We have various talented designers, developers, and engineers. Now, let's go back, take it back a little bit to GitHub State of the Octoverse 2019. Now, if you look at the chart I just showed now, where open source is growing, we have about 59% growth in Nigeria, which is really, really crazy. We also have about 44% growth in Kenya, and we've had a growth from about 40% in Tunisia and Morocco. And to just show you how much Africa is like, developers from Africa are really doing the whole open source. I really take it open source seriously. We can see that Nigeria has the highest growth in open source. Nigeria is a country in Africa, my home country. So now let's just see a little bit of what GitHub is saying about Africa. So we have about 65% growth in Kenya, in Morocco, Nigeria, Egypt, South Africa. I mean, we Nigerians, the entire Africa is taking open source up to the next level, and we've had collectively about 70% more contributors this year than last year, which is like a really insane stats for open source. Now let's talk about a certain a community in Nigeria and Africa that is helping to spread the gospel of open source. Oscar, so Open Source Community Africa. Open Source Community Africa is like a community of creatives driving the open source movement in Africa. It was basically created to encourage more African developers to contribute to open source and also advocate for open source movements in Africa. The most beautiful thing about Oscar is it is diverse. It's it provides a community for both designers, for both technical writers, for both developers to come together and contribute to open source. So Oscar demographics. Just before I move forward, I'm also part of the organizing team for Oscar. So we are currently in about 5 countries. We have about 11 cities and 1,000 plus members in Africa, and we are about to see more growth in the coming months. So this is like several photos from various meetups that we've had. We've had meetups in Kenya, Zambia, various parts of Africa to sit down and talk about open source. So Oscar project. So we had the open source festival. We started the open source festival earlier this year in February, and we had like a large number. We have about 800 to 1,000 people coming together from all parts of Africa and also Europe. We had people from Drupal, we had people from GitHub, we had people from Google. We also had sponsorships from Facebook, Google, GitHub, and it was really, really nice to see people coming together to talk about open source here in Africa. We also encourage diversity. Like I said, we also have the Women on Oscar, which is a joint effort with She Code Africa to introduce and train more women and girls into open source. So we also partnered with Open Collective to create a bounty program so that people that are contributing to open source can also get paid here in Africa while contributing. So there's a certain number of bugs that are available on the Open Collective repo, GitHub repo, with bounty tags on it. If you check it out now, you will see it there called tag Oscar. And like I said, we have a very diverse communities of both developers and designers. So Open Source Design Africa, this is an effort by the design team of Oscar to help designers also get started in contributing to open source. So connecting with Oscar, do you want to know more about Oscar? You can also check the website, oscar.org. You can also follow them on Twitter and also donate to Oscar on Open Collective. Now, so while we are talking about various communities, we need to talk about certain people that have helped grow the growth of open source in Africa. So like I was, so the very first person I would like to talk about is Samson. So Samson Gordy is also a GitHub star and part of the GitHub README project. He's a software developer who believes in changing the world and is an open source advocate, and is also maintaining Sugar Labs while on the board of directors seat. Oscar is also the co-founder of the Open Source Africa. Samson is also the co-founder of Open Source Africa, and he currently works with the UN and UN Women to bring more women into technology. Next person is Ada. So Ada, she's the founder of She Code Africa. She trains girls and provides a community for girls to learn and women to learn how to write code. She's also the co-founder of Open Source Africa. She's also a developer advocate at Google. So in February 2020, she and her team hosted about 1,000 plus Africa developers to the largest Open Source Africa Open Source event here in Africa, tagged the Open Source Festival, like I said. The next person is Prosper. So Prosper is an open source advocate, he's an evangelist, and the CTO of Eden Life Inc. He's one of the pioneers, the key pioneers of open source movement in Africa here. He's a regular speaker at developer events around the world. One very insane start that helped Nigeria get recognized as one of the people pushing for the open source movement. In 2016, Prosper beat out top companies like Facebook to trend number 2 on GitHub. Only Google was above him on the list of trend developers. I mean, Google is a whole organization, and Prosper is just a single person that was able to top other companies like Facebook and etc. in the list of trending developers, which is like a big win for Africa. I think it was during this time that companies outside Nigeria, outside Africa, began to take a shift towards seeing what we are doing here in Africa. The next person is Abigail. So Abigail is a product designer and an open source design avocado, an advocate. She has over various years of combined experience in technology, focusing on web and product design. She also is a speaker here at the All Things Open. Very excited to see her talk. And she loves open source and is passionate about helping people learn how to grow as open source contributors. She basically pushes for more designers to go into open source. And if you have noticed over the years, a lot of people think that just pushing open source is just for developers. But Abigail here is trying to change the narrative that even designers can contribute to open source. And Marlene is a Zimbabwean explorer. She's a speaker, and she's from the city of Harare in Zambia. She's also an advocate for social for science and technology for social good. She's currently the director and the vice chair for the Python Software Foundation, and also on the chair of Python Africa. She's currently pursuing a computer science degree with the University of London. Marlene has over a very good number of years contributing to open source and also in providing a community for developers to get into open source, and including designers. The next is Segun Adebayo. I mean, a lot of people from around the world do not know Segun Adebayo is the creator of Chakra UI. The Chakra UI is a very popular React component library that helps you create accessible websites and apps with speed. On GitHub, the project is hosted on GitHub. It has about 10,000 stars, which is really, really great. And it's one of the biggest projects, open source project that's come out of Africa. He's also a design engineering manager at tradelink.com. He also co-founded Career Lift. Segun is a very, very big open source advocate here in Africa. When he started Chakra UI, we saw how Chakra UI grew from just having one star to having over 10,000 stars and having recognitions from all over the world with people like Kent, very big open source players in the world using Chakra UI and giving very great feedback about it. We are proud of him here in Africa, and we are looking so forward to see more stuff, more open source projects from him and other people. So notable OM open source projects and communities from Africa. Like I said, Chakra UI, a very, very huge VR component library with a lot of people using it all around the world. And we have Image AI. This is like an artificial intelligence project by Moses. Moses is, I think he's currently software engineer at Microsoft here in Nigeria. The project has about 5,000 stars on GitHub and has a lot of people using it. Then Danfo.js, it's a JavaScript library for data structures, for presenting data in structures, etc. Made in Nigeria. So Made in Nigeria is a GitHub repo that consists of most of the open source projects that has come out of Nigeria. It's a community of open source developers here in Nigeria and designers here in Nigeria. So, we share their projects, and the project is currently hosted on GitHub, and you can always like find out and by clicking the link. So I attach the links to every single point project that I'm dropping here. Code for Africa. So Code for Africa is a community where people come together to talk, to teach people how to code, from kids, children to women to just basically if you want to get into coding and also open source. Code for Africa is there for Africans. Open Source Community Africa, like I said, I spoke about Open Source Community Africa as one of the largest open source community we have here in Africa that is trying to change the narrative of how people see open source here in Africa. So Material Pay Night Team. I purposely put this here because, I mean, a lot of people here, we use VS Code, and Material Pay Night Team was created by Olaolu Olawi. He's currently a senior UX developer at Shopify. He built it here in Nigeria, and it has about 300,000 downloads, which is really, really a very, very good mark for us here in Africa. It's currently hosted on GitHub, and you can always find the link to it. You can use it. It's a really, really great team. We had people like Sarah Drasna. We have people very, very good, big players in the open source talk about Material Pay Night Team and how useful it is. We've had various people make certain look-alike teams from the Material Pay Night Team. Now, the Free Software and Open Source Foundation for Africa. So it's basically headed by the UN, and it basically brings people from various parts of Africa to come up and learn more about open source and also learn more about coding. Now, how to provide support for OSS in Africa. I think Erica said something generally about how to provide support for people in open source, but I want to like narrow it down to just Africa. We need more people to sponsor, more companies, more organizations, more foundations to sponsor OSS events in Africa. Currently, we had just Open Source Community Africa pushing for this event. We also need to provide OSS. We also need these companies and organizations and foundations to provide OSS learning supports for people here in Africa. We also need to we need more OSS initiatives established here in Africa, because a lot of people are still like lacking behind when it comes to open source. A lot of people still don't understand what it means. So when more initiatives are created for people to see how open source work, a lot of people don't understand it, then we would see a better increase in open source here in Africa. We need more people to provide a voice for African OSS creators and contributors. There are a lot of OSS creators and contributors here in Africa doing great stuff that they are hardly recognized. So we need people to help us reach out to these OSS creators and the contributors here in Africa, get them on interviews to talk about their products, talk about things they are doing. It really serve as an incentive for more people to get into open source, because a lot of people feel like they're not appreciated enough because, I mean, they're Africans, but when we provide an enabler environment for people, for OSS creators and contributors, then we'd have a better increase in open source contributions here in Africa. So one very important is hire more folks from Africa. I mean, we have great people here that are working, that are very intelligent, very brilliant. I mean, when companies come here to Africa to see that we have good people providing open source support, doing a lot of open source contribution, you would see that this will provide a sense of like, okay, this is great. So we can currently start providing more support for people here in Africa, and this will increase the growth of open source here in Africa. I mean, there are a lot of open source companies around the world, so this isn't something that should be that difficult. Also, one very last point is promote open source from Africa. GitHub has been doing a very great job promoting open source here in Africa with the README project. I mean, talking about Sonia, a lot of couple of Africans that are Samson down the README project. We have Samson, we have Sonia, we have like a long number of people from Africa here that GitHub have decided to promote, create a voice for them, more people to hear about their story, etc. So So yeah, that's basically it for my talk, for my keynote talk. Thank you everyone for listening, for taking your time to listen to my talk. This means a lot to me, and thank you to the organizers for giving me the opportunity to talk about open source in Africa. I have a talk tomorrow on the international track. If you want to hear more about open source in Africa, you can definitely jump on the talk. Thank you so much and enjoy the rest of the conference.